using YouTube and Facebook for remote service delivery. COVID-19 is limiting physical interaction between child protection actors and communities, but we can still share critical information with those who need it most using technology. YouTube and Facebook are both useful platforms for communicating key messages for children, adolescents, parents and caregivers, as well as staff or volunteers. Both platforms are appropriate for one-way sharing of key messages, and although Facebook allows two-way messaging where viewers can respond to content, it's best to avoid this option. Let's take a look at the pros and cons of each platform and how we can use them safely. YouTube is useful for several reasons. You can set up an account for free and use it to host unlimited videos. Those viewing your content don't need their own account. You can make your content visible only to those you invite. Individual pieces of content can be blocked, and you can block users from commenting on your content. However, there are some potential online safety risks associated with using YouTube. Some location data is shared, and this cannot be switched off. You cannot control the suggested content your viewers see, and this may not always be appropriate. And don't forget, before posting any videos online, you need to get permission from those appearing in these videos. To use YouTube safely, you can control who can see your content. To do this, navigate your video in your YouTube studio. Under Visibility, select Unlisted, then click Done. Your video will not appear in any YouTube searches and will not show on your channel. People will only be able to find and view it if you share the link with them. You can set your audience. To do this, scroll down to Audience and select Yes, it's made for kids, or No, it's not. You can then choose to set a minimum age of 18 to view the video. With this setting enabled, viewers will need to be signed into a YouTube account to signal they are over 18 before viewing your content. You can also block comments. To do this, go to your channel, click on your videos, click Settings at the bottom left of the screen, choose Community from the options that appear, then click Defaults. You can now choose what to do with comments on new videos or on the Discussion tab. Choose whether to disable all comments or to add a partial or full review of comments, then click Save. If you have a small amount of video content to share, a Vimeo account is a good alternative to YouTube. Now, let's take a look at Facebook. Facebook allows you to create specific pages and invite specific users to access them. It's widely used, so its functionality is well understood, and location sharing is switched off for under 18s. But there are some risks. It doesn't allow staff members or users to be anonymous. Fake user profiles can be created with no identity checks, providing opportunities for predators to groom and exploit children. And there are few controls over content, which can often be violent, illicit, or extreme. To use Facebook safely, you should post as the page, not as yourself. With admin rights to the page, this should happen automatically. To check, find a place where you could comment on a post. This should show you who you will be posting as. To interact with the page as yourself, click View as Visitor, then click Exit View As to return to interacting as the page itself. Ask a colleague to join you as an admin or moderator for your group or page so they can help you monitor behavior and comments. This may involve deleting specific comments or, in the worst case, removing certain users. If necessary, ban people from your page. To do this, click Settings at the top of your page, then click People and Other Pages. Search for the person by name, click the cog icon, select Ban from Page and click Confirm. Restrict who else can post. To do this, go to your group, click on the three dots and choose Edit Group Settings. scroll down to the post approval and check the box beside the option stating all group posts must be approved by admin and click Save. You will now receive a notification when someone submits a post and will be able to review it and choose whether to post or not. In times of crisis, YouTube and Facebook can play an important role in taking critical information to children and their families.